When you hear the word Skoda, you probably think of comfortable, practical family cars like our Kodiaq Scout long-termer here.
Dig back into the Czech manufacturer's history, however, all the way back to 1957 in fact, and you'll find something very special indeed. The Skoda 1100 OHC race car. And I'm joining the small group of people who are lucky enough to say that they've driven it. First though, a potted history of this very special car. It's powered by a heavily modified four-cylinder motor from a Skoda Tudor road car, developing 93 horsepower at 7,700 RPM. That might not sound a lot, but this tiny race car weighs a barely believable 550 kilograms, thanks to fiberglass bodywork, a thin-walled tubular chassis, and the lack of any safety kit like a roll cage or even seatbelts. The cabin is seriously tight. Getting in feels more like putting on a big pair of trousers. You put both feet on the seat and lower yourself down onto the pedals, which in my case means having my knees up by my ears. But what's the Skoda 1100 OHC like to drive, and how does it compare to a modern Skoda? Well, let's find out.
Right, yes, so a few immediate differences then. Obviously this car hasn't got a roof, and I'm not used to wearing a helmet in our seven-seat Kodiaq SUV.
It's also very different to drive. The steering is unassisted and the drum brakes need an almighty push before they start to work.
Size is a bit of an issue, if I'm honest, both for me and the car. This was obviously designed for an era where racing drivers will whip it thin and built like racing horse jockeys. I am neither of those things. I am just a fat man in a balaclava.
The weight of the driver was even taken into consideration when finalising the position of the engine, so you could easily ruin all of that good work with a big Sunday dinner.
There's not really any of the safety systems that a modern motorist has come to rely on. There's no electronic brake distribution, there's certainly no traction control, and actually there's not even any seatbelts. That means this is pure distilled driving! I'm doing all of this, not some fancy software algorithm. And to be honest with you, it's absolutely terrifying. This car is worth £250,000 and there's only two in the world, two!
The modified engine gains a new cylinder head with two camshafts, twice as many spark plugs as normal, and features a pair of twin choke side draft carburetors too. It runs on normal petrol now, but the original regularly used aviation fuel to get maximum power and could reach 124 miles an hour.
The noise is just phenomenal. You shouldn't really be listening to me talking right now. You should be listening to this engine. Woo-hoo-hoo!
Before long though, our hour was up and it was time to bring the Red Racer back into the pits. I could have happily stayed out all day in this fabulous machine. It's the ultimate expression of Skoda's simply clever tagline, a car weighing barely half a ton that offers terrifying speeds to anyone brave enough. It's an experience I certainly won't be forgetting in a hurry.